Hey everyone, this is Higinio. This is Higinio Talks. I'm laughing because I was just laughing with my nephew about the funny sensual nature of this video, but I wanted to go through with it. So today, I want to talk about friendship. We're going to discuss that. Friendship, just a few thoughts on it, really. And how it's been embedded into our society. Friendship is important. I think what it does is it, remember, we always want to be secure first before we can layer on top of that security and grow or have fun. I like to always say those things because it's important for both. In order to have fun, you have to have a certain trust, and then in order to grow, you have to have a certain trust as well, and you have to kind of communicate so you know the goals. And communication is important, but what happens is when people meet, there's a lot of assumptions that are already made. And if you come from two vastly different cultures, it's important to communicate, or different parts of the world, or different states, or just different societies, simply because the assumptions that you make are going to be different. People are going to have certain assumptions on you. Assumptions are important because we need to be able to get to this level of growth very quickly. And so we learn to make assumptions called, we just want educated assumptions based on things we've experienced in the past. We make assumptions on age based on what someone looks like. We make assumptions on what someone might like based on their gender, things like that. I think a lot of those are important and they're safe. And the reason they exist in our society is because we want to get to that core growth stage. It's us establishing security. And if we can assume certain things are true, then we can jump straight to the growth because security is there. But when you do go into an environment or when, something like that. If someone gets into a taxi cab, they're always going to maybe exchange words with the driver or something like that first to kind of establish a sense of safety or security. It's always safe to do things like that in the environment, or if you're in like an enclosed space of some sort. So we were talking about friendship and why it's important. It's a way of creating this security, but of course everyone is born alone and it's gonna die alone, and so that's a truth. And so what you want to do is you but we also know that we can't be alone completely. We depend on others. We're interdependent. We're humans, right? And so what that means is we have to find the warm medium between the isolation that we're born into and that we'll die into, and so we try to find ourselves in someone else. We want to find the most congruency, the most comfort and security that will allow us to be ourselves fully, the way that we were naturally born. And so the more we can express that without any kind of friction or that's kind of the environment that we're kind of drawn to. And so that's essentially what we're looking for. Our mind is going to be trained as we grow up to accept certain things. Of course, we're not going to be mating with, we're not going to choose an ape as our mate or as our girlfriend. But it is possible to have a good relationship with an ape because they can communicate with sign language. And you can too. One of us could too. And so it'd be really interesting to see what kind of ideas they would share, right? So you can create a bond with any other energy force, a puppy, an ape, another human, and based on what we've been taught in life and how our minds have been opened or not opened, we can accept different kinds of love. And so that can be, some people are scared of dogs. They may have been traumatized by them in the past. Some people love them. Some people love cats. Some people hate them. Some people are racist. Some people are not racist. All of this is just how we're kind of like socialized, I guess, is one way to say it. I don't like to use too many terms that are very embedded into the educational system because we want to encourage a free thinking process where ideas stem from within you and something that everyone can relate to. This is a faith-based world is having you having faith in your beliefs and thoughts. So with friendship, we establish friendships in a way to to survive until we die alone. But we do want to, but it's a natural thing. None of this is sad. You know, there's a growth energy and a death energy within us all. So there's always usually one that's more prominent. I think I'm a life energy. But I have to be balanced out with the tranquility and the calmness of the more calm death energy, I suppose. But a friend's pretty much just take the place of something more permanent when the time is found or when you find it. And I do think that because we live in cycles, we're constantly going to be. If for any reason we are incongruent, what happens is we feel that and we start to desire more from the universe. The universe will bring that to us. It's always going to bring us what we desire the most at an unconscious level. So if we think it or if we are aware of it in some way, form, or fashion, the universe is going to present it to us and it's going to bring it to us. And we have to be aware to connect. The universe is throwing us a hook and we have to be able to hook back at the same time to lock with the universe. And so we will grow out of love or out of a connection with some people and we'll grow into a connection with someone else. And there's always something to be grown and it just depends. It doesn't mean that we'll grow out of everything, but it does mean that we have to be I just have an awareness because the universe is giving us what we want. So when we have it, we have to enjoy it. We have to refuel it. There's cycles that we go through where and we have to learn to like always balance out those cycles. So we'll have times of high energy or low energy, and we have to and our partners or our spouses, the people we're our loved ones, people we're around, they're always, you know, in order to benefit. To live well with them in the moment, it's you kind of have to do the same thing and balance out the energy around you. Sometimes it's okay to hang out with someone, and sometimes, you know, hanging out with them for a long period of extended period of time can be draining. It all depends on how the energies match up, how they're willing to, you know, to continue adapting or anything like that. So friends are essentially a security blanket until we can find something more permanent. Now men tend to have friendships that are very action-oriented, men tend to be very efficient in general in their thinking. They're very practical is what I find. And I think that women tend to be more intuition-based, more they pick up more in the world. There's a lot more build-up. Now, these qualities are actually in both genders. It's just how the world has come to present them. So there's a trait that this society has said is okay for women to display, and there's a trait that they have said guys are okay to display. But really, we're all we get caught up in these things, but really we're all equally balanced, and we have a balance of both energies, and we have to have a way of displaying those together. So as a friendship, we want to build it. We want to maintain it. I do think that there's kind of a surface world and kind of like a deeper world of meaning. And on the surface world, that's where friendships lay, I think. It's like a small talk, hi, bye, like, oh, someone loves me out there. But it's not real love or even real anything. It's kind of like just creating an illusion of love to kind of get the ego by. Underneath, though, is what really matters. I think that women, you know, a lot of people that maybe extroverts, maybe people that are very intuitive, not just women, but predominantly women, they come from the top layer. You know, you have to scrape off a lot of the fluff to get down to the core, the cake. You have to scrape the icing off. Whereas men are more are not just men, but other but in some women, they tend to be the inside. They're more the core, more meaning and values, and then you have to add. There's a lot of like. Character there, and then you have to add the fluff on top. So at the core, you have the intentions, your urges, what you want, what you value. You know, you just go for it. Very directness. That's what directness is associated with masculinity. And so these tie into to friendship. I think it comes on the surface level. I think that if there's a friendship on a surface level, you know, a lot of women have those types of friendships, or they're very ego based. It's for minds that are like more simple. It's just. It's something that doesn't involve a lot of obligation, and I think it just teases the mind that there's significance there when there's really not. I think it's a very passive thing. That's why people have a lot of friends sometimes, or they go through them. Now on the real on the other side of that, we have a core connection. A lot of those connections can be like sexual because it goes to the rawness of things, or it can be just like a deeply intimate bond, but you know, like fully trust. So it can be like not just physical intimacy, it can be complete non-physical intimacy, but intimacy is, this example, something that can be a part of the actual cake and not the icing. So just my take on friendship and what it is on the surface. And I think that the reason I was bringing it about women is they do propagate this more. You won't find a lot of guys, friendships are going to be more direct, more core. They get together for activities specifically. They have values. They do things they want. There's a lot of fluff and yapping and a lot of with a lot of women. Now, there's a lot of fun stuff too. I mean, it's all surface and non-surface, but just to say that a friendship has to be a balance of both, I suppose. But eventually it gets replaced with something real and deep and intimate. I think that, and that's what I guess a relationship is. So that's why I say a friendship is kind of like something on the surface that kind of keep us going, a little bit of coffee, a little bit of self-esteem boosting. But I think that if those are the types of things that boost your self-esteem, if that's what, then I don't think that's such a, I think there's deeper things. I think that after a certain level, we do not want that. We want more out of a certain than a surface experience from the things around us.